Yes, Admiral, the Senator is right about the information having to be leaked to the public. It is the only way our plan has a chance to work.
I understand, ma'am. But my question is, how much do we give away and how deep do we go? This is a very dicey situation we're dealing with.
I'm aware of that, Admiral. Put it this way, as the security expert from Cyber Command, it's your job to see that we go right up to the brink without actually stumbling over it. This cover story has to be totally believable. So we're going to have to divulge some classified info along the way.
I understand, Ambassador. Have you sent the additional interviews out yet?
They should be here today. After that, coordinate with Admiral Linden at his home.
Great. Thank you, ma'am. Now, I have a training flight to Miramar and back this afternoon, so I'll review the documents and I'll call the Admiral late this evening.
Perfect, Admiral. You can give me a full report at the dinner on Saturday.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Let me get to my secure phone. Hang on.
Okay, Admiral, I'm here.
We've more or less established your agent's chain of custody from Spain all the way to that Cape Kilo place.
What kind of documentation did Senator Bertrand give you?
I have interviews in front of me from the German team at Ronda all the way to the station chief at the rendition site. And even the Navy chopper pilot who got her the hell out of there.
That's good. I want every detail. I want every stop along the way.
Okay, she was picked up by CIA contractors in Ronda, probably on a side street near the Bull Ring. She was taken into custody and put on a private Learjet at Seville Airport. That plane, by the way, originated from Algeciras, flown to a chartered airfield in Miami for refueling. Then after less than 30 minutes on the ground, they headed directly for that Camp Kilo site in Panama.
Any documentation on that? I mean, other than the interviews.
Yes, sir. I have a transcript of the flight plan and the actual voice recording of the pilot. Plus, I have a copy of the base log at Kilo when they landed, got her back into the brig.
Anything on her interrogation or how she spent her time there?
No, none, sir. And if there ever was, it went straight into the burn bag, I'm sure.
I guess I already knew the answer to that question. What about her release? Anything on that?
Let's see. We do have a transcript of Ambassador Hazelton's phone conversation with the station chief, Ron Wilcox. And we also have a very bogus-looking report here that was signed by Wilcox and by Agent Colton.
Anything else?
Well, there's this one thing. The Navy chopper pilot saw fit to put in his report, and is a good sailor, by the way. Quote, upon takeoff, the subject asked if we could do a napalm run over the base, or maybe even strafe it. End of quote. What do you think of that, sir? Was she serious?
She was dead serious.
Opened the door and I saw Seaman Cullen, I was thoroughly impressed. Hello, may I help you?
Hello, sir. My name is Seaman Denise Cullen. I'm looking for Admiral Reilly.
She was a lady that was obviously bright and very, very able to try to learn. I took her into the bubble and gave her her first security briefing. And this looks like a regular garage, but it's not. This is what you call a secure compartmentalized information facility. This is totally soundproof. No electronics can come in or out. This is a very safe place. Some people call this a bubble. Seaman Cullen, today we're going to start your orientation for your new job and your assignment to Special Section. You'll be working with me and other people, other covert agencies around the world.
Did you tell her about Special Section?
Yes, ma'am. But you know, it was only the need to know stuff.
Go on.
Then I gave her all the equipment she would need. This special drive, this gizmo, is what you are going to be using in our business. And I also gave her all the documentation, told her she had to read this.
Did you happen to mention to her that this was all an elaborate trap and she was the bait?
No, ma'am. I thought I would leave that to you.
That wasn't part of his briefing, Sue.
Continue, Admiral.
Lastly, I told her she was promoted 2 grades.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I'll never forget that look on her face. How proud she was. How young, how vulnerable this lady was. God, I just hope this works.
It'll work. As long as everybody does their job.